Ooh, what it do, what it do, what it do, what it do, ooh. And we're gonna keep the ball bouncing. So we're gonna keep the ball bouncing like this. This is another request by my boy Frankie V. Cause he said I got to react to this one. So we're gonna check it out. So without further ado, the motherfucking show must go on, man. Oh, excuse me.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was Cypress Hill, No Rest for the Wicked. Wicked. Alright, y'all. So, we're going to hear the response to that from Ice Cube. Because if it's a diss track, y'all, I'm going to put it in verse mode. I'd rather put it in verse mode. So, shout out to my boy Frankie, to my boy Frankie V. I'm going to add this one to it just for you, bro. Just for you, Frankie. So, without further ado, the motherfucking show must go on.
Oh, yeah. It ain't over, motherfuckers. These niggas don't understand. Every few years, niggas got to get their motherfucking cats peeled back. Nigga, this Westside, nigga. Don't think, son, nigga, don't think. Now, next motherfuckers go by the name of Cypress Hill. K.O. motherfucking day. Every few years, niggas think they can deal with the real. Now I got the fuck Cypress Hill. I got a voice you should fear. I drink a beer, bust a rapping in your fucking career. You fucking cowards, never seen a hood high power like the West Side. Whooping on your motherfucking ass. That's what you got illusions of, bitch.
Yeah, nigga, you's a bitch. Dog, we ain't got no niggas like you on my side. Nigga, this ain't a wood. Red Society. Check it out. We waiting for round two, you punk ass motherfuckers. And anybody else that wanna get some, stand in line. But bring a lunch, motherfucker.
All right, y'all. Now, the votes are in, and I want y'all to tell me whose side are you on, Ice Cube or Cypress Hill? I mean, you still could like both. I'm not judging you, but just during that era, during that time, who you think that won that battle? So, everybody leave me their motherfucking comments. But, man, you hear that beef between both tracks? Like, because, like, you know, Cypress Hill was, like, even back then, like, Cypress Hill was, like, you know, underground, but, I mean, Ice Cube was underground, too, but he was more at the mainstream level of underground. But you could hear from both sides, though. You could hear from both sides, like, bam, bam, you know. But at the same time, you know, it's a good thing we all broken that fucking stereotype now. It's a good thing. But at the same time, though, during that time, you know, I was more of a Cube fan than Cypress Hill, you know. But I did like Cypress Hill music during the time, but it was just, you know, it was just the stuff that was like out. But you know, not a lot of cities they don't sell like a lot of underground nigga, and especially coming from the West Coast, from the area where I'm from, yeah, it's supposed to be all West Side music, supposed to be for sale, but shit, fuck it, it's not. It's all mainstream garbage. I mean, don't get it wrong. There's some mainstream rappers I like too, but I'm not talking about that. But after that though, me personally, I had to go with Cypress Hill because There's No Rest for the Wicked. That was a dope ass track. So I'm gonna have to go with my vote for Cypress Hill, y'all. You know, I do like B Real's music. I do love Ice Cube music. They're, you know, B Real's one of my new favorite MCs because I barely got into his music, and But I do love Ice Cube music because he's up there on my idols list. But after that, y'all, I got to rate both tracks a 5 out of 5 out of 5 with 10 burning mics. But after that, peace, love, smoke weed every day, and stay tuned for the next episode. And let's see who do I got coming up next. Yes, Cypress Hill versus Ice Cube. Man.